Welcome to second part of our lecture on the public policy draft preparation and the follow-up action as part of public policy and introduction, the program of MOOC, the MOOC. In the last episode, we have understood how a public policy draft emerges, or public policy brief emerges out of a problem. Now, I gave the example of problem of child labor. Now, I will take a different example. All governmental offices are supposed to serve certain welfare activities like giving a ration card, giving a caste certificate, or offering a revenue certificate, income certificate, or any other certificate, age certificate, so that he is eligible to collect pension, so on and so forth. So, this is the duty of a department of the government. If you are a municipal corporation, you have to give permission for the construction of houses. If you are a water supply department, you have to offer the connection. So, you have to tell that within this time, I will accept your applications, and within this time, I will consider the application, and within this time, if it is fulfilling all the conditions or requirements, that will be taken up, or if it is not fulfilling any conditions, it will write a letter to or inform you that you have to supply so and so document, you have to give some proof of so and so residence, then you have to do that, and thereafter, you have to issue the permission or the certificate which is being sought within a prescribed time limit. This is called citizen's charter. A public authority has to provide a citizen charter and announce it in their website or in their notice board. This is called information being suo moto given by the public authority itself. What information you give, like a railway timetable? Railway timetable has to be prepared by the railways department, and they have to announce. They have to tell it's at 6 o'clock so and so train will come and take you to so and so place. At 7 o'clock this train will go. That 8 o'clock some train will go from this platform on this day, twice a week or every day. So who else can give better information about railway timetable other than railway department? Similarly, every department has a responsibility to tell what they are going to do and what kind of services they offer to the people. This is called informing the people about your own services, which is again described as citizen's charters. Now, if you have said that a house construction application will be received by 7th of every month, it will be considered before 15th of every month, and requirements will be fulfilled by 20th of every month, and by 25th we'll issue certificate. That means within 15 days from 7th to 25th, we'll give you the construction permissions letter. So, this is the service, and I am entitled to this service. How do I get entitled to this service? You are not doing it. You are taking money. There is a huge corruption in government departments. You take money to accept application. You take money to accept the documents. You take money to give final permission. If this is this has to be removed, you must have a policy of guaranteeing a time frame service of various activities that your government department offers. So, this is the suggestion of this is policy statement. Time frame is a citizen's charter, but time frame policy statement doesn't have a enforceability, doesn't have any force of law. It is not mandatory. So, I have to spend my money for this welfare. It's only a suggestion. I have to give information about my department to you. It's again a suggestion. Or if you take the example of a family, a husband has to maintain his wife, proper relations and proper nourishment, proper shelter, proper clothing, proper fooding. All this is the responsibility of the husband and who is a earning member of the family. Similarly, he has to take care of elderly citizens. That means their father, mother and others who are dependent upon him, who nurtured this fellow all through the life. Now, it is his responsibility to take care of them. These are all normal, moral, cultural, traditional and legal responsibilities. If they don't do it, what is to be done? How do you force the son to take care of his father in his old age? So, there is no force of law or there is no enforceable legislation to deal with it. Now, this is the problem. Make a policy brief saying that there shall be a legislation by which the son is under a responsibility to take care of his father, mother in their old age, and if not, prescribe certain remedies. There will be an imposition of fine, you say. Or if your father's property is given to you and you are residing in that house, you will give it back to father. Or you will pay a certain amount of rent to your father. Or if you have already rented out your property to some other fellow, evicting your father into streets, then you have to get back your fathers into your apartment or house and remove the tenants, and so that they will have a peaceful, secure residence. These are the welfare measures. So out of problem, a policy brief emerges. Out of policy brief, if government of particular state or government of India accepts, policy emerges, policy brief emerges or evolves into policy approved and accepted by the executive government. You might be hearing that in a cabinet decision, government has decided to enact a legislation called Public Services Legislation, to enact a legislation called Right to Information Act, or to enact a legislation called Right to Education Act. So these are all based on the public policies which evolved out of a problem, and some group studied and offered a policy statement, and the policy statement is corrected by a secretary's committee of the department, so concerned department of government of a particular state, and based on the report given by the secretary's committee, law department is consulted, finance department is consulted, other departments are consulted, their opinion is also collected, and a policy is framed and put before the cabinet, and cabinet discusses it and then frames out an outer line or an outline as to what to do and how to implement this policy and what is the financial implication. Now, after studying the financial implication, it comes up with a policy. If that policy is approved and implemented, fine. For example, a pension has to be given an old age person at the age of 60 for so and so income group. This is the policy. Finance department allocates money after the policy was approved by the cabinet. Simple. You don't need a legislation for this. Come on, implement it and everybody is happy. Suppose there is a need for legislation like senior citizens protection, senior citizens welfare, abandonment of senior citizens should be made a crime, punish the children with penalties and various kinds of hard measures. So that requires a legislation. So the policy brief transforms into policy by the government, and if government considers that there is a requirement of a legislation, it will bring up a legislation, otherwise it will implement the scheme. So this is called the second phase of public policy being transformed into the policy approved by the government, and government will do, implement it. For example, prohibition. Suppose you don't want any liquor to flow in this country, in this part of the city or in this part of the state, and because of consumption of alcohol, people are misbehaving both in the office and at home. In one of the states, all the wives of the labor came to police station and protested, saying that all our husbands are beating us and depriving us of our maintenance, and they are consuming the entire salary entire salary is being spent on alcohol and boozing. They are boozing away their salaries. So bring the legislation. That was the demand. So a problem is reflected in a representation. A problem is understood and reported by a committee. A problem is studied and resolutions and solutions are suggested by another body. All three put together becomes a policy brief. And if policy is accepted by the government, it will become policy of the government. Sometimes it is available in the manifesto of that particular party which came to power. It will say, okay, I will impose total prohibition. We will not allow any alcohol to be sold in so and so territory. And for that you need a legislation. Then you constitute a drafting committee to draft a legislation. So in the next episode, we will try to understand how a legislation is drafted to enforce a public policy which is evolved out of a problem that is prevailing in the society.